Hi students, now we continue with refraction of light. You may be thinking when this refraction will get over. It will take some time because this is a big topic. And around 10 marks to 12 marks questions come from this part of light, that is chapter 4 and concise. So it's a big topic and a lot of questions come in that. Section 1 may be 4 marks, section 2 out of the 10 mark question, 4 or 6 mark questions are mostly from this part. The rest will be from lens and spectrum, which is also part of light. So totally light comes for around 18 marks, these 3 topics. Out of that 18 marks, around 10 to 12 marks is from chapter 4. So it's a very important topic. Maybe in this and one more video lecture, we may finish the topic. But after that, I have to do the board question answers with all of you. I know that you will be having your perception of answers, but unless the keywords and scientific terms are all there, you don't get full marks for the answers. So some of the answers, I will be writing it down and you will have to copy those prints. And we will be discussing that also. So this refraction of light will go on for 2 weeks. After refraction of light, I will start with sound, because that is what most of the schools have started. So I will do sound after this. So now we continue with total internal reflection and see the distinction. What is the difference between total internal reflection, which usually happens with a prism, and reflection from a plane mirror? Now that every one of us know, we all have mirrors in our house. So we know about reflection in a plane mirror. First of all, last time you saw what are the two conditions when total internal reflection happens. That is the first point. The total internal reflection will happen only if the ray of light is traveling from a denser to a rarer medium. Like we saw, it was traveling from water to air. So then total internal reflection happened. And the second condition is that the angle of incidence has to be greater than the critical angle for that pair of media. So that is one condition, the two conditions. Whereas reflection, all it is required is that the incident ray should be falling on a plane mirror from any medium and at any angle of incidence. As long as the incident ray of light falls on a plane mirror from any medium at any angle of incidence, then reflection will happen. So all you need is the ray of light to fall on the mirror. So which is advantageous? Of course, that is why we use a mirror. Because it is not that you are standing at some angle, only then you can see yourself. You can see yourself whenever you are standing anywhere in front of a mirror, you can see the reflected rays. Now second case, this is what makes total internal reflection very useful. The entire, that is 100% light energy gets reflected. Hence, the energy of the incident ray is equal to the energy of the reflected ray. This is why people prefer a total reflecting mirror, a prism, instead of the mirror. In mirror, the image is less bright. Whereas in prism, which is total reflecting prism, due to total internal reflection, I told you the word total is there because it is 100% reflection. Whereas in case of mirror, only a part of the light is reflected, while the remaining is reflected and absorbed. Only a part of it is reflected. The remaining part of it will be refracted and absorbed. It should be refracted and absorbed. So it is refracted and absorbed. The energy of the reflected ray will be less than that of the incident ray. So it is not 100%. Only a part is reflected. And the last point, see, you would have seen in your, especially in your bathroom mirrors, where there is moisture, the silvering of the sides gradually fading off. So whenever there is humidity or moisture, or in a room where the geyser is kept, so there the silvering gradually goes off. Even in the hall room or any mirror, gradually the silvering goes. So that is why this doesn't happen in case of a total reflecting prism. That is a second advantage of total internal reflection. So if you are asked advantage of total internal reflection, then you will write these 2 points. Whereas if you are asked distinction, you can write any of these 3 points. So the third point is the image is much brighter and the brightness remains unchanged even after long use of the total reflecting device, namely total reflecting prism. So it remains forever, it remains unchanged, the reflection remains unchanged. Whereas in case of plane mirror, even if it is not damaged or anything, with time the image becomes less bright and the brightness gradually decreases as the silvering on the mirror becomes old and rough. So when the silvering becomes old and rough, the brightness decreases. So what are the advantages of total internal reflection over reflection in plane mirror? Not the first point, it is the second and the third point. So sometimes question comes, distinguish between. You can write any two of the 3 points. If it's a 2-mark question, then for distinction between, there has to be 2 points written this side and 2 points written that side, corresponding points. And if it is advantage of total internal reflecting prism over a plane mirror, then you have to write points 2 and 3 only. So advantage is only points 2 and 3 and not the first point. Copy all this in your notebook. Now see, there could be a question asked in the board exam usually for 2 or 3 marks which ask you to complete the following ray diagram till the incident ray emerges out of the prism. So you have to use the diagram which I had given you, the 4 cases. That is, if angle of incidence is 0, which means if the ray is going along the normal, then the ray goes undeviated straight. Second case, which we had done in that, was if the angle of incidence is less than the critical angle, then normal refraction occurs, and if the ray is traveling from denser to rarer medium, it will bend away from the normal, and if it is traveling from rarer to denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. Then the third case in that, which we had learned, was if the angle of incidence happens to be equal to the critical angle. So now you need to remember what was the critical angle of glass. It was approximately 42 degrees. So here, in this case, for this prism, I am writing critical angle of glass is 42 degrees. So 42 degrees, if the angle of incidence happens to be equal to critical angle, then angle of refraction will be how much? 90 degrees. That is, the ray just graces the surface of the two media and it will come along the surface. And the last case was, if the angle of incidence is greater than this critical angle of glass, then what will happen? Then the ray will get totally internally reflected. So in all the cases, what are we looking at? The angle of incidence, and comparing that with the critical angle of glass. So in each case, by using geometry in that triangle, you have to figure out what is the angle of incidence at that point. For example, ABC is a 30, 60, 90 degree prism. So that is already given to you. Your question is only this much. Now you have to complete the ray diagram. You have PQ is an incident ray, and it is incident at AB along the normal. So now what will happen at the point Q? The ray will go straight, undeviated, till it reaches the surface of AC. So the ray here will travel straight, undeviated. Why? Because it is along the normal. At point Q, what is the angle of incidence? 0 degrees, not 90. The angle of incidence is 0, because it's the angle between the incident ray and the normal. Now this point, if I call it as R, if I name this point as point R, I have to use a little bit of geometry. This is linear pair, so this angle is 90 degrees. So what is this angle out here? The angle ARQ will be 60 degrees, Why sum of angles of a triangle is 180? So is that the angle of incidence? No. This is not the angle of incidence. The angle of incidence is the angle between this incident ray QR and you have to draw the normal at point R. So now next thing I have to do is draw the normal, and normal should look perpendicular to that surface. Huh? So this normal has to look perpendicular to AC at point R. So now once I draw the normal, this angle is 90, out of which ARQ is 60. So the balance angle of incidence is 30 degrees. So if this is the normal at point R, the angle of incidence is 30 degrees. So every place where the ray is incident on any surface, I have to figure out what is the angle of incidence and then compare that with critical angle of glass. Here angle of incidence is less than critical angle of glass. So what will happen? Normal refraction. The ray will go from glass to air. So because it is traveling from glass to air, it will undergo normal refraction and it will bend away from the normal. So the ray goes away from the normal this way. So it is traveling from denser medium glass to rarer medium. So QR will bend away from the normal. Now you can't tell what is the angle of refraction exactly, but you can definitely write R is greater than 30 degrees because it is bent away from the normal. So R is greater than 30 degrees at the point this RS, the angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incident. So RS is bending away from the normal. And since this is the normal to this surface, this angle is 90 degrees. So that is how you complete the ray diagram. This is the full ray diagram. PQ went straight along QR, along the normal. At R, we figured out that the angle of incidence is 30, which is less than critical angle of glass. So the ray bent away from the normal. Angle R is greater than 30 degrees. So that is angle of refraction. So this is the angle of refraction. So this is the complete ray diagram. In this case, you are not required to explain anything in writing. If they ask you what is the phenomenon exhibited at point R, you will say it is refraction. The ray is traveling from denser glass to rarer air, so the ray is bending away from the normal. So here there is no total internal reflection, it is normal refraction. Now it depends where the incident ray is. For example, now we will see the second diagram in which the incident ray is not falling here. But let's see what happens if the incident ray is falling on this surface. So you can't mug up a diagram, you have to relate the angle of incidence to the critical angle of glass. Now the next diagram. As I told you, here the incident ray PQ is incident at the base BC. So the position of the incident ray is now different, so the entire diagram becomes different. Now this is again that same 30, 60, 90 prism. So now what happens at Q? You know it. The ray goes undeviated straight ahead. The ray is traveling along PR. So now next thing, what you have to draw, you have to find what is the angle of incidence at point R. You need to first find what is the angle of incidence at that point. So you know this angle is 90 degrees, it is a linear pair. So in this triangle, this angle out here will be, since this is 90 and 60, this will be 30 degrees, sum of angles of a triangle. Then you draw the normal at the point R. At this point R, you draw the normal and then figure out, because normal is perpendicular to the surface, so here the angle of incidence is 60 degrees. 60 and 30 will give you 90. So the angle of incidence is 60 degree, and what is critical angle of glass? It is 42 degree. So at point R, angle of incidence is now greater than critical angle. So when angle of incidence is more than critical angle, what will happen? Total internal reflection will happen, provided the ray of light is traveling from denser to rarer medium. Provided the ray of light is traveling from denser to rarer medium. So now here, because the ray is traveling from glass to air, total internal reflection happens, and here the ray gets reflected back into the same medium. Into the same medium, and before you draw this ray, you will have to ensure that what is the angle of reflection? It will be 60 degree. If the angle of reflection is 60 degree, why angle of incidence and angle of reflection will be same. Here also, in total internal reflection, all the laws of reflection are obeyed. So therefore, this ray will go at 60 degree, means that ray will be 30 degree. The rest of it, the rest of the angle will be 30. So this ray will go like this. You will have to figure it out whether it makes an acute angle or an obtuse angle. See, I told you this angle is going to be 30. Why is that going to be 30? Because this angle is angle of reflection, which is 60. These two angles are same. Why? 9th standard you learned laws of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. That is also applicable in total internal reflection. So 30-30, so this angle has to be an obtuse angle. How much will that be? 180 minus 30 minus 30. So this angle will be 120 degree here. So here you have to think a bit and complete the ray. So this ray RS is the ray which has got totally internally reflected. Now what will happen at point S? The ray has not come out of the prism. Your question is, complete the ray diagram till the incident ray emerges out of the prism. So till it comes out of the prism. So now at S, what do you do? How do you find the angle of incidence? You have to draw the normal, the perpendicular to AB at the point S. When you draw the normal, that angle is 90. So here what will be angle of incidence? The remaining, that is, this angle was 90 degree. So when that angle is 90, then the remaining angle of incidence at this point is 30 degree. So when angle of incidence is 30 degree, compare that angle of incidence to critical angle. Angle of incidence is less than critical angle of glass. So the ray will bend away from the normal. It will go away from the normal. Instead of traveling straight ahead, it will bend away from the normal and go along this path. So that will be the final ray, that is PQRS, and you can call it T. And here, can I find the exact angle of refraction? No. I can only say that angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incidence. So I can say that angle of refraction is greater than 30 degree. So ST is the final emergent ray. So see what difference is there between this diagram and that diagram. There the angle of incidence was 30 at point R. So the ray just went out, this diagram was over in point RS. RS was the emergent ray. Whereas this ray was incident here. So therefore you calculated angle of incidence here to be 60. More than critical angle. So total internal reflection, in which angle of incidence and angle of reflection are same. So there the angle ARS was found to be 30 degree, because the normal 90 minus this angle of reflection 60. So because these two angles are 30-30, this has to be 60. So you couldn't draw this ray straight. Because if you draw the ray straight, that would mean that this angle is 90. It has to be 120. So you have to show ASR as an obtuse angle, not as an acute angle or as a right angle. So draw this diagram. You don't have to explain anything anywhere. But if they ask you what phenomenon is exhibited at point R, you will say at point R because angle I is greater than critical angle of glass. Angle I is 60 degree is greater than 42 degree. Therefore, total internal reflection occurs at point R. So that is what is happening at point R. And at point S, what is happening? At point S, what is happening is normal refraction of light. Please copy that diagram and mention this. Now look at this diagram. The same prism, 30, 60, 90 degree prism, but now the ray is falling on the surface AC out here at the top part. And if you extend that line, you will see that it is going towards AB. In the question paper, you have to be careful when you extend this, where is it going and falling? Is it landing at AB or is it somewhere here and landing at BC? That will make a lot of difference to the figure because the angle of incidence will differ. So now in this case, when the ray is falling here at 90 degree, angle of incidence is 0, the ray goes undeviated, it will come straight. This is the normal, so 90 degree. So here you have 60 degree because sum of angles of triangle. So now here what is angle of incidence? The angle of incidence out here is 90 normal minus 60. So angle of incidence is 30 degree at this point, that is point R. So at R, you compare angle of incidence to critical angle of glass, which is 42 degree. So what will happen? No, not total internal reflection, but total, it's just normal refraction, because it is less than critical angle. So the ray, instead of going straight, will bend away from the normal. So now, angle of refraction will be greater than 30 degree. P, Q, R, and this is S. So here the ray diagram ends here. There is no total internal reflection in every case here. So this is the third ray diagram. Copy this. Now we will see if the ray is incident like this. Normal, but it is going towards the base BC. That will be another case, another diagram. Now look at that diagram. The new diagram which we are going to complete now. The incident ray PQ, when you extend it, it is clearly going towards the base BC. So that's the difference between this question and this question. Here the incident ray was going towards AB. There it is going towards the base BC. So angle of incidence is 0, or the ray is incident along the normal. So the ray travels undeviated straight. So now here this angle is 90, this angle is 30. So what will happen? Here the normal has to be drawn. When you draw the normal at point R, what is the angle of incidence? This angle, angle between incident ray and normal. See, angle of incidence is not this 30. This is the angle between ray and surface. Angle of incidence is the angle between incident ray and normal. So this angle, angle I, will be 60 degree. And critical angle of glass is 42 degree. So what will happen to this ray? It will undergo total internal reflection at point R. So the diagram will be very different from this. So here the ray undergoes total internal reflection. Angle of reflection will be equal to angle of incidence, so it will be 60 degree. So this angle will be 60 degree. So obviously this is 30. This angle will be 60 because it's again another 30, 60, 90 triangle here. A small triangle. So now what will you draw at the point S when the ray RS hits the surface S? Yes, first you will draw the normal. So first you will draw the normal here. What is this angle now? Angle of incidence, new angle of incidence is 30 degree. Because this 60 minus from that 90. So angle of incidence is 30 degree. So therefore, what will happen to the ray? It will undergo normal refraction because angle of incidence is less than critical angle of glass and the ray, instead of traveling straight, will bend away from the normal. So instead of going straight, it bends away from the normal. So it will come along ST. ST is the final refracted ray. So what will you find? You will find that the angle of refraction here is greater than 30 degree. You can't tell what is the exact angle unless you use trigonometry and find using sin I by sin r as refractive index of glass. So, but that is not ever asked because you are not given sine table and all in the exam. So you don't have to bother about that. So this is the complete diagram. Don't forget to name the different points P, Q, R, S and T. And here at which point is total internal reflection shown? It is shown at point R, where the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle and the ray is going from denser to rarer medium. So draw this diagram. Now instead of 30, 60, 90 triangle, we will see another triangle. Let's say an equilateral triangle and see what happens in that. So now here I used a new prism. 60, 60, 60 or equilateral prism. So all the three angles of the prism are 60 degree and ray PQ is incident along the normal on the surface AB. So it will go straight, undeviated, and here it is going towards AC as shown in the question. So the ray goes straight, undeviated. This angle is 90, that angle of the prism is 60. So obviously by angle sum triangle, that is that property, you have that angle will be 30 degree. Because sum of all the three angles of triangle is 180. So now you draw your normal at this point. Let's call that point as R. When you draw the normal, normal is perpendicular to the surface. So the entire angle is 90, out of which 30 is gone there. So angle of incidence becomes 60 degree. So if angle of incidence is 60 degree, total internal reflection will occur because critical angle of glass is 42 degree. Due to total internal reflection, now the ray will come, let's see whether it goes straight. Here the angle of reflection is how much? This angle is also 60 degree. Why? Law of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So what is the balance here? The balance is 30. 60 and 30. So this ray has to fall along the normal at this surface BC. Why? Because it will form a triangle with the third angle at 90 degree. So when you draw this, be careful that this ray is along the normal, so when you extend, that ray will come out straight. So PQR, S and T, this angle will be 90 degree. So here you are seeing that because this angle SRC was 30 and the angle of the prism at C was also 60, so the ray RS was coming down straight along the normal. So it goes undeviated and ST is the final emergent ray. In all these prism diagrams, what do you see? There is deviation. There is deviation. In this case, what is the deviation? The incident ray was going like this, it came like this. So the direction of the incident ray and the direction of the emergent ray, the angle between the direction of the incident ray produced and the direction of the emergent ray produced backward, that angle would be the angle of deviation. Always remember in prism, what is the net effect? Deviation. We have written what are the factors affecting angle of deviation in a prism. And what is the deviation in case of parallel sided glass slab? Zero. No deviation, no angle of deviation. In parallel sided glass slab, the net effect was sideways shift, that is lateral displacement. And in the first lecture, we had seen in the first or second video, the factors affecting lateral displacement. So be careful when some question is asked, what is the angle of deviation in some case. So now, next we will see one more figure before we go to the next part of the chapter.